is good. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, for his steadfast love, for his mercy, for his grace endures forever. Come on, anybody come to give thanks unto the Lord? Come on, anybody glad to be in this house? Anybody glad to be at home and awake? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We come into this place today to thank God, to worship him for all that he has done for us. God, we thank you for who you have been in our lives, for all that you have done and for all that you're ever going to do, God. We thank you for answered prayers. We thank you for making a way out of no way. We thank you for breath in our bodies. We thank you for another chance. Come on, this is not a new song. Won't you sing with us this morning? Won't you stand on your feet and acknowledge his presence and acknowledge everything that he has done for you that you could not have done for yourself? Only God could have done it. Oh.
So much for me.
We are so thankful to you, Lord. Great is thy faithfulness. Oh God, my Father, there is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not thy compassions. Oh no, they fail not. As you have been, you forever.
Lifting that up only if you have something to be thankful for. Keep lifting up those words only if you have something to be thankful for. I'll give you a moment. Only if you have something to be thankful for, lift up your voices. Let God know that you are thankful. Thankful for His grace. Thankful for His mercy. Thankful for that we have a reasonable portion of health and strength. Thankful that our kids are doing okay right now. Thankful that our minds are where they need to be right now. Thank you that I can put one foot in front of the other right now. I am thankful. It's prayer time. It is prayer time. So if you want to, you may come up to the altar. If you feel better standing where you are, maybe you can reach someone close to you. To get connected. You will see names on the screen for those of you at home and those of you here in the sanctuary. You can see names on the screen. We all are standing in the need of prayer. So lift somebody up. A name that you see on the screen or someone that's in your heart right now as we pray. Most precious and eternal God, our Father, as the words have already been put in the atmosphere, Lord, we say thank you. You have been so very good to us, and we say thank you. You have been so very good to us, and we say thank you. You have been so very good to us that our hearts cry out, thank you. God, we appreciate everything that you have done for us. We thank you for seeing us through. We thank you for bringing us through. We thank you, God, that you were with us as we were going through. We thank you, God, that you are the supreme God. You are almighty. You are the most powerful God. You are the only God. And Lord, we thank you that we can right now stand before you with our heads bowed, knowing that you not only can hear our cry, but you can do something about our pain, something about our concerns, something about the worries that we have. God, we know that we can call on you, and you are a prayer answering God. So Lord, we give everything over to you on today. God, we ask that you would be, show yourself strong and show yourself mighty as we are battled with this Satan who is doing, only thing he can do is, or he's doing what he does best and try to kill, to steal, and destroy. God, we ask you to be strong and mighty as we face the battles that we come up against. We ask you, God, to be strong and mighty in our lives. As the devil tries to throw everything at us, even the kitchen sink. But God, we know that you are the powerful God, that we can stand behind you, O Lord, that you can stand us up so that we can face anything that comes up against us because we have your power. It's not our might, it's not our strength, O God, but it's by your power that we can overcome. God, we ask that you would just to cleanse us of all things that have been unrighteous in your sight. Thank you, O God, for your forgiveness. Thank you, O God, for your guidance. Thank you, O God, for your leadership. Thank you, O God, for covering us. Thank you, O God, for protecting us. Thank you, Lord, for seeing us through. Lord, we just cry out, thank you. Thank you, God. We ask, O Lord, that you would bless those who are suffering now, God, those who are in their homes, the sick and the shut-in, those who are bereaved on today. Thank you, God, for blessing them. Thank you, God, for being their peace. Thank you, God, for being their comfort. Lord, we ask as we hear the word through a pastor that you have prepared for him, that somebody's heart would be changed, that somebody would walk out of here better than what they came in like, oh God. We ask, oh Lord, that someone would give over their life today, thanking or asking you to be their Lord and their Savior. And God, as we move through this service, we ask that your spirit would reign, that you would fall down, their spirit would fall down on us, oh God, that it would cover us, oh Lord. We lift this prayer up, oh Lord, in the name of your Son who died for our sins. He was nailed to the cross. He gave up his life so that we could have life and have it more abundantly. It is in Jesus' name we pray. Let every heart say amen.
Amen. As you return to your seats, won't you remain standing? and join us in our morning hymn. Lead me, guide me. Lead me, guide me. Hallelujah. Say, lead me,
lead me,
guide me,
guide me,
along,
along the way. For if you lead me, I cannot stray.
Lord, let me walk.
So good to be in the service again. To our family, friends, guests here and at home, and those watching at Lakeview Post Acute, good morning. I am Disciple Chris Bartley, and I welcome you to the historic Central Baptist Church, where we are still making disciples and transforming lives, and where the Reverend Anthony L. Riley serves as our pastor. We hope you will enjoy today's worship experience. Now, if you are visiting family and friends in the sanctuary, we are so glad that you have chosen Central as your place of worship this Sunday, and we invite you to come again. Everybody, if you know, just want us to get all cozy, we're a real loving church in here, so if you could just look to your left, look to your right, just give them a real big smile and say good morning. Make everybody feel real good this morning. Now, if you are worshiping online, please comment your name and where you're from in the post or chat. We would like to greet and connect with you. Central is a social media friendly congregation, so upload photos and or reels of today's worship experience. Be sure to tag the Pastor Riley and our church. Now pull out your phone, like, comment, and share the live stream. In addition, for those of you that are in the sanctuary, we have for your convenience QR code cards. Now on the back of the they're on the back of your chairs to request care and to give. We encourage all guests to scan the QR code now and let us know you are here. We want to personally acknowledge you. Once again, I'd like to thank you and welcome you to Central Baptist Church, and thank you for coming in today. Now, if there's anyone in the sanctuary that is celebrating an anniversary, we'd like to recognize you. Is there anyone here celebrating an anniversary? Will you please stand? Anybody? All right. All right. Nice. Okay. Anybody in the choir? Okay. All right. So, Mark, how long? 18 years. Yeah, I don't look but 35. All right. How many years? 25. It's a halfway mark, man. You're almost there. 25. It's been so long, you just get lost in the years, right? Happy anniversary to each couple celebrating an anniversary, and I pray that God continues to bless you and allow your light to shine for others. Now, this is the month of April. Stop it. Stop it. It's, really? That's what we're doing? If there's anybody in the sanctuary, clearly we see it's our pastor, that's celebrating a birthday this month, will you please stand? All right. Nice. It's your birthday today. Yes, we're going to really celebrate you today. You. No, I'm just joking. All right. We want to, and anybody watching online, will you just, you know, let us know that it's your birthday. But right now, we'd like to sing happy birthday to you, Central style.
What?
Happy birthday, happy birthday. I wish each and every one of you many, many more. Eat yourself a big old slice of cake. You deserve it. Again, I want to welcome you to Central Baptist Church. And now, here's what's central to you.
Officially celebrating 178 years, welcome to the historic Central Baptist Church. We are still making disciples and transforming lives. It's April 14th, and here's what's central to you. April is sabbatical month at Central, allowing our church the chance to rest, recharge, and reflect. Sunday school, Sunday worship, children's church, youth worship, Monday and Wednesday prayer, and Wednesday Bible study will continue. All other ministry meetings and events will resume in May. Let's be still and spend time listening to God. So, join us for Bible study. What do diverse groups believe? Make It Plain, Jesus, Sex, and World Religions returns this Wednesday in person at noon and at 7 on Zoom. All are urged to observe the National Day of Prayer on Thursday, May 2nd. Pray with Central on Zoom at both 7 a.m. and 7 p.m. and fast from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. For additional events scheduled around our area and throughout the country, visit nationaldayofprayer.org and pray. Lord, send us a revival. Be sure to bring others with you to our 7 p.m. nightly 3 Tuesday Spring Revival in May. On May 7th, Central welcomes back from Indianapolis, Indiana, Reverend R. Janae Pitts Murdoch. On May 14th, from Fairfield and Susan City, California, presidential candidates from our National Baptist Convention, USA Incorporated, and for his first time as Central, Dr. Claiborne Lee Jr. And on May 21st, friend of Central from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, Reverend Dr. William H. Curtis. Help spread the word. The Siteman Center Mammography Van returns to Central to offer breast cancer screening to women with appointments beginning at 8:30 a.m. on Saturday, May 18th. Invite those in your circle. For those without insurance, this vital test is free. Schedule your appointment by calling the numbers listed here and on our website, powered by the Health and Cancer Support Ministries. With Earth Day coming next week on April 22nd, how about joining the Green Team? Spring is here and we need help to get our central gardens at the corner of Reverend T.E. Hunley Avenue and Olive together. Let's plant, weed, harvest, compost, clean, use social media, and canvas the neighborhood to help Central build our surrounding community by advocating for food security. Maybe you love nature or playing in the dirt. Whether you are a gardener or not, a disciple at Central or not, age 5 or 95, all genders are welcome. To join, see these wonderful people. Email greenteam@cbcscl.org and follow CBC Green Team on Facebook. And for more of what's central to you, connect with Central's Rome community online or by app and check out the church calendar, newsletter, and more at thenewcbcscl.org. My name is Kennedy Eatwin, and I hope you all have a blessed week.
Amen. Well, this is the day the Lord has made. We've gathered to rejoice and be glad in this day. Yeah, today is indeed a good day, and we thank God for this day. I simply want to say thank you. Oh, hey, what's up, Jordan? Hey, welcome home. Good to see you. My high school students is here. I just want to say thank you to some of you that show love to, pardon me? College. What did I say? Yeah, she grown. Yeah, welcome back from college, from university. Yeah, that's what it is. Which means she's in college, and you know what that means. She's broke, yeah. And so, do I have a witness? Okay. And so, just slide that way over to her and put something in her hand, okay? Not something that jingles, something that folds. Am I talking right? Okay, yeah. So, stop by and see Jordan before you leave. What did you say? I'm preaching now? Put it in her hand, not her mother's hand, all right? Every dollar goes to shenanigans on campus, amen. I simply want to say thank you to so many of you who have expressed your warm birthday wishes this week, to the Pastor's Aid team and that noonday Bible study on Wednesday. We have a great time in study and fellowship, and I was blown away by the presentation that we had. So thank you for coming out and having a good time together. It means more to me than you will understand. But may understand more in the days to come. So thank you for that. All right, let's worship the Lord through giving. All right. Rosie, would you please come? If you need an envelope, please raise your hand. Giving begins with the purple envelope. Our tithe is 10% of income, interest, and increase. Above the tithe is our offering. There's also a burnt, what is it, orange, a burnt red envelope. There's a sample there that Rosie has. Talk more about that just a moment for our capital campaign. Rosie.
Thank you, Pastor. Good morning, Central. As the pastor said, I am Rosie Savage Threats, and I'm going to provide a very brief update on our capital campaign. As you are probably aware by now, the theme for the campaign for this phase is investing in hope. And we have four phases that we're focused on for this part of the campaign. The first one is the garden area. The Food City has offered us a $10,000 grant. That is, if we raised $10,000, they would match it with another $10,000. Amen. And we learned from disciple Leroy Grant last Sunday that we've raised just over $10,000. So hallelujah. So those funds will be used to teach the community and families how to grow fruit, grow food. The produce from the garden will be used for our community meal, as well as to provide for those who are in need. The second area is for our youth. We'd like to create some space in the Claiborne Educational Center where they can be safe, connect, and grow in their relationship and understanding of the Lord. And then the third area is for the physically challenged. We'd like to make sure that even the physically challenged, right? Everybody gets an opportunity to have access to all that Central has to offer. And then the final area is the roof for the warehouse. Some of you probably saw the condition of the roof when you took the tour with Trustee Stephanie Royal at the end of last year. The roof is leaking. It's over 20 years old. It's quite damaged. We've had several folks come out and look at it, and the consensus is clear that the roof does need to be replaced. And now that it's, since it's raining, since it leaks when it's raining inside, did I say that right? Okay. So it's also caused some damage to the interior of the warehouse as well. And so we obviously want to be good stewards, right? God has given us this asset that we will eventually use to provide service to the community. But we want to make sure that we're able to put that roof in the condition that it needs to be. So just a specific update on where we are with the campaign. We've had 68 disciples and one visitor contribute, and 23 of the 68 have given $356 or more. So if you have not made the commitment to contribute, we encourage you to seek God's guidance on this and everything. If you have made the commitment to contribute, we encourage you to do so today. There are special envelopes that have been made available to ensure that your contributions are allocated properly to this campaign. And I know it seems like this campaign is going to go on for a long time. It started March 2025 and will run through March 2024 and will run through March 2025. So it's easy to say next week, next month, next year, but we would encourage you to take a listen at what John chapter 9 verse 4 says. We must quickly carry out the task assigned us by the one who has sent us. The night is coming, and then no one can work. So let us continue the legacy of 178 years of investing in hope for the common good, for the community, but most importantly, so that God gets the glory. Thank you.
Amen. Thank you, Rosie, for that announcement. We're now ready to give. We bring, first of all, God's tithe, 10% of what God's entrusted to us. Over and above that tithe, we bring the offering. We are walking for the offering. I'm going to pray, and I invite the section to my far right, my far left, and the center to stand first. After they have given, the sections on my right and left, you will stand as well and be directed by our ushers from the rear. I'm going to ask everyone who is able to stand and to walk to please do so. If you're giving electronically, just put your phone in your pocket, walk on around. You need to exercise and get your steps in while you're in church. Amen. Let's pray for this offering now and receive generously what God has given to, a portion of what God has given to us. God, thank you for gift and giver. Receive these generous gifts now as the expression of our love and trust for you. We commit now this tithe, this offering, this campaign contribution, so the Central Baptist Church continues making disciples and transforming lives. In the strong name of Jesus, those who agree said together, amen. God bless you. As you give, would you stand? Would you stand? Would you stand? Thank you. across the room. If you're able to, all across the room, and turn with me to Amos chapter 5. Amos chapter 5. And I'm going to read just two verses into your hearing from this prophetic text, Amos chapter 5, verses 14 and 15. Seek good and not evil, that you may live. And so the Lord, the God of hosts, will be with you, just as you have said. Hate evil and love good, and establish justice in the gate. It may be that the Lord, the God of hosts, will be gracious to the remnant of Joseph. That's enough. If you'll help me to preach this, look at neighbor in the eye, look at him in the eye. If you don't like him, look at him and smile at him. And tell him, neighbor, your life matters. You may be seated. Yeah. That's what I want to preach today. Your life matters. Look back, tell him, your life matters too. Your life. Encourage me. Let me encourage you. Your life matters. True. Don't get it twisted. Aren't you sick and tired of people questioning whether or not your life matters? When was the last time you wondered yourself, does my life matter? Would it surprise you to know that life gets like a jungle sometimes? It makes me wonder, thank you, Katrina, how I keep from going under. July 2013, after the assassination of Trayvon Martin and the subsequent acquittal of his murderer, George Zimmerman, a movement was birthed, hashtag Black Lives Matter. Gained steam and momentum right here in Missouri and New York City after assassinations of Michael Brown and Eric Garner. Black Lives Matter is a positive affirmation in a culture of legalized public lynching, today known as self-defense, inequality, racism, classism, discrimination, and police brutality. The movement advocates very simply for systematic policy change so that the laws protect all people, even if your skin is black and brown, provides for liberation of those who are oppressed. Do you believe that Black Lives Matter? Not only do Black Lives Matter, we learned a couple years later that Blue Lives Matter. In fact, there are disciples and friends connected to Central Baptist Church who are serving or have served faithfully in law enforcement or the armed services. Let's praise God for them today. In direct opposition to Black Lives Matter, this idea crept up that to say that Black Lives Matter was anti-police. So what happened in the wake of some homicides of police officers, especially there in Brooklyn, New York, there's this movement now to let people know that blue lives matter too. We care for our law enforcement. We have to have a society with a critical balance between good law enforcement, just laws, gainful opportunities, and wraparound service. Need all those things together. But then to push it to deny the recognition of racism at all, and racial violence against African Americans, to shift the debate or to utterly avoid it altogether, was this new slogan born that says, all lives matter. And as much as we claimed Bill and forgave him, in June 2015, his wife, then Democratic presidential candidate Hillary Clinton, in a black church in this state said, all lives matter. Candidate Martin O'Malley went a step further in 2016, and he used this term, white lives matter, as if we didn't know that already. Black Lives Matter has been denounced as a divisive term and as a racist term by the former president. And I'll say less about that. But by the show of hands, let me ask you a question. Can you be honest? Who in here has experienced or know someone personally who's experienced racism? Discrimination. Shopping while black. Racial profiling. Bullying. Microaggressions. Teasing. Hair shaming. Color shaming. God knows this thing is real. So yes, white lives do matter. Yes, all lives do matter. Yes, blue lives do matter. But I have no problem, thank you, Sable, proclaiming at Central Baptist Church that black lives matter. Forget what has happened to you, what you have experienced. If God be for you, no matter what the color of your skin, who can be against you? Your life matters. Would you just help me and encourage someone? Tell them your life matters. Tell them it matters. It matters. It matters. And you wouldn't believe the struggles that your neighbor has gone through just this week. I know you get the nod at the grocery store. You get the look, the glance at the job. But somebody in your vicinity, somebody who reports to you, somebody on your row, on your job, in your HOA, needs to see you and hear you say, "Yo, I see you, my brother. I see you, my sister. Your life matters, too." Some child needs to know your life matters. When they're in their phone and walk right past, no, stop, young man, stop. Young woman, I know what you've heard on the radio, what you've heard in music. Your life matters, too. Somebody wants to know, what God did this by making you fearfully and wonderfully. You are God's masterpiece, God's handiwork. God took God's time when God formed and fashioned you from your lips to your hips, the texture of your hair, the tone of your voice, the way you walk. Nobody has slap swag like we do. Nobody can slay like you can. God did it just like this. And I hear you. I hear you saying, "Pastor, is this just some pop psychology, some new age, nice cotton candy religion, make us feel good about ourselves and come back next week?" I understand there's a supermajority in the state house. There's a strong minority in the people's house. I know that they're asleep in the White House. But in the face of all that you have to face, you have purpose and you have destiny. You are here for a reason. If I can help somebody, as I travel along, if I can help somebody with a word or a song, if I can help somebody from doing wrong, then my living will not be in vain. I'm on Bible ground, Galatians chapter 6. So let us not grow weary in doing good. Here it is. For we shall reap at harvest time if we faint not. Your life matters, so please do right. I'm sending the text, verse 14. Emma says, "Seek good and not evil, that you may live, you plural, your community may live, and so the Lord, the God of hosts, will be with you just as you have. So you've been talking about how God is with you, but I can't see fruit in your life. Do right. Do the right thing. No matter what the world throws at you, do the right. No matter what the world throws at you, do the right. Whatever the world throws at you, do the right thing." God wants some congruence of those who have God's name between what we say about God and what we do. They ought to be the same. God says, do the right thing. Doing the right thing is not always doing the easy thing. Doing the right thing doesn't always make it the popular thing. But God says, seek good. I want you to do this. Make this thing happen. Some of y'all remember that 1989 classic, Do the Right Thing? Remember that movie? Spike Lee. And it portrays these racial tensions in a neighborhood in Brooklyn. How is it that an establishment can be in a black neighborhood supported by black people, funded by black dollars, frequented by black folk, but on the Hall of Fame only include Italian actors? That was the question then, and the question now. How is it that some establishments can be in our neighborhoods, supported by our people, funded by our dollars,
frequented by our people, and we don't have ourselves represented on the wall. There's got to be a way to do the right thing the right way. Now, hear me clearly. Doing the right thing the wrong way is not justified because you're acting on behalf of God's name. But every now and then, you've got to buckle in and put on your seatbelt and hold to God's unchanging hand and do just what God said do. It may be the road less traveled. You've heard that Robert Frost poem, The Road Not Taken. Two roads diverged in a yellow wood. And sorry, I could not travel both. And be one traveler long, I stood and looked one as far as I could to where it bent in the undergrowth. Then took the other just as fair and having perhaps the better claim because it was grassy and wanted wear. Though as for that, the passing there had warned them really about the same. And both that morning equally lay in leaves no step had trodden black. Oh, I kept the first for another day. Yet knowing how way leads on to way, I doubted if I should ever come back. I shall be traveling this with a sigh somewhere ages and ages hence. Two roads diverge in a wood, and I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the difference. Every now and then, there are these critical junctures in life, and the choice you make makes all the difference. The choice to do right, to say right, to show up right, it makes all the difference in your life and those who are around you. I'm in Bible ground, Matthew 17. Jesus says, enter through the narrow gate. For the gate is wide, and the road is easy that leads to destruction, and there are many who take it. For the gate is narrow and the road is hard that leads to life, and there are few who find it. You know how we do. We opt out of what is right when we can't immediately see the benefit or how it will work out or how it works out for our favor. So you have folks who are with zeal but no knowledge being against women's rights as if it somehow impacts men. Being against civil rights as if it impacts the majority. You can be for other people and be for yourself. Do right because it's right. Do right because a tide rises all ships. Do right because perhaps if one crab gets out the barrel, we can tip the barrel. All the crabs can get out. Do right. And don't break the glass ceiling, but remove the glass ceiling because if it shatters, glass falls on all of us. Do right. Amos's name means burden. So he's not telling you what he wants to say. This is what God has spoken to him. He has been seen as a burden. Here comes that burdensome prophet. Perhaps he was a burden in childbearing. Sisters can affirm with me that every time you have a child is the pregnancy an easy one. Challenges you go through. Perhaps Amos was a burden in bearing. Perhaps as his mother had him in the womb, he was hard to carry. But God kept him anyway. Perhaps he was a burden in his rearing as a child. Some kids just pick it up later on in life. You keep praying for them, keep reaching out to them, keep providing. You don't know when they'll turn around. They get to be 10 and lose their mind, get to 20 and lose their mind, get to 30 and lose their mind. Some of them are 50, 60, 70. But every now and then, God will snatch them back. You have to stay doing right. Perhaps he was a burden in rearing. He was definitely a burden in hearing. Because he was a prophet saying stuff people didn't want to hear. He said stuff like, can two walk together unless they agree? He said stuff like, but let justice roll down like a river and righteousness like an ever-flowing stream. We have work to do because all of us have work in the master's hand. Your life matters when you do right. I'm done. And when you be just. I know grammar there isn't quite right, but it's good theology. You've got to be just. He says, verse 15, hate evil, love good, establish justice in the gate. It may be that the Lord, the God of hosts, will be gracious to the remnant of Joseph. Be just. It's not just enough to do right. Amos says, I want you to be just. You can do the right thing for the wrong reason. You can do the right thing with the wrong motivation. You can do the right thing because it is politically expedient to get elected, to get the black vote. There's a difference between doing just and being just. Don't only go through the motions. Don't do it to appease your neighbor or save face. Watch this. Don't even do it to hear God say, well done. Because I hear Jesus in Matthew 7 saying, not everyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, will enter the kingdom of heaven, but only the one who does the will of my Father. On that day, many will say, Lord, Lord, who did not prophesy in my name. Didn't we cast out demons in your name? Didn't we do mighty works in your name? And I will declare to them, I never knew you. Joel told us last week, yet even now, says the Lord, return to me with all your heart, with fasting, with weeping, with mourning. Tear your hearts and not your clothing. How's your heart? Help us, Isaiah chapter 58. You fast only to quarrel and to fight and to strike with a wicked fist. Such fasting as you do today will not make your voice heard on high. Is such the fast that I chose, a day to humble oneself? Is it to bow down the head like a bulrush and to lie in sackcloth and ashes? Will you call this a fast, a day acceptable to the Lord? Is not this the fast that I chose? To loose the bonds of injustice, to undo the straps of the yoke, to let the oppressed go free, and to break every yoke? Is it not to share your bread with the hungry and bring the homeless poor into your house? When you see the naked, to cover them and not to hide yourself from your own kin. Then your light shall break forth like the dawn, and your healing shall spring forth quickly. Your vindicator shall go before you. The glory of the Lord shall be your rear guard. God says, when you move like I move, I'm right behind you, lockstep every step of the way. God cares about your doing and your being. Do you really care? Or is it a photo op? Is it branding for you? Is it a feel-good moment? Psychology says we have 5 categories of human needs. And these categories drive all of our behavior. There's the need for self-actualization, the desire to become the best that we can be. There's the need for esteem, the need for respect and self-esteem, status, recognition, strength, and freedom. There's a need for love and belonging, the desire for friendship and family and intimacy and a sense of connection. There's a need for safety, personal safety and security and employment, resources and health and prosperity. There's need for the physiological, air for the body, air and water, food and shelter, clothing and sexuality. He says, you have all 5. Economy says, what should drive you is capitalism. Whatever makes the most profit, go do that. Declaration of Independence says that what should drive you ought to be the freedom to enjoy life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Here's what we all want to know. What's in it for me? And all that stuff has its place. But for the child of God, for the disciple of Jesus Christ, underneath all of those other factors is another motivating factor, which is the substratum. It undergirds, it supports, it supersedes, it filters, it focuses all the rest. Here it is. Come here, Jesus. What is the greatest commandment? That you love the Lord your God with all your heart, mind, soul, and strength. And the second is like to love your neighbor as yourself. Don't just do right, but be right. Amos says, perhaps God will do something that will wow your mind. Perhaps God will save. Perhaps God will heal. Perhaps God will bring some stuff together when you start doing and being as God called you to be. The Bible says that 1 can put 1,000 to flight, but 2 can put 10,000 to flight. The Bible says if 2 or 3 agree on anything, it shall be done. Imagine what could happen if we started doing right and being right. Imagine what God could do if you gave God your little fishes and loaves. It just may be that God will turn this world upside down. It may be that God will use 1 Rosa Parks to help spark a movement. God needs just 1 Anna Julia Cooper, just 1 Frederick Douglass, just 1 Harriet Tubman. Just 1 Sojourner Truth. Just 1 W.E. Du Bois. Just 1 Dred and Harriet Scott. Just 1 Medgar Evers. Just 1 Madam C.J. Walker. Just 1 Booker T. Washington. Just 1 Fannie Lou Hamer. And I'm searching around Central Baptist Church on today because God has issued a call at Central. Are you the one? God's looking. Are you the one? are you the one who's placed your life in God's hands? Because you know your life matters to God. And it just may be, that the God of grace will be with you. It just may be that God will turn things around. It just may be that you, God, will turn your life around, and your life will turn your family around, and your family turns your neighborhood around, your neighborhood, your community. It just may be that God is with you, because I heard the psalmist say that the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not walk. He maketh me lie down in green pastures. And hurry on, he says, you prepare a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. You anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. Is anybody here who says, I'm living in the surely, surely grace is following me. Surely mercy's behind me. I've had some dark days. I've been through the dark night of the soul. But every time I look behind, those twins are following me. I've got grace. I've got mercy. Every time I put my hand in God's hands, I find those twins after me. Our God's not a slot machine. Surely goodness and mercy. Your God is not an ATM. Put in the right code and God blesses you. But surely God will come through. Yes, yes. Surely you have some uncommon favor. Yes. I'm done with the sermon, but I can't leave without celebrating what God did with those girls who were from the school in South Carolina. Carl, thank you. I'm so glad that every now and then, through the darkness of the night sky, comes the brilliance of a new dawning. Yes, and I heard Dawn say, Dawn is the coach of those young women. She said, yes, after their historic championship win, she says, when you lock in and have a belief and have a trust that this is what can happen, they made history when they were an unlikely group. She says, God is funny like that, that God will rip your heart out and then God will make you believe the unimaginable. Is there anybody here who says, that's the God I serve? I still believe in the unimaginable. I still believe in the unattainable. I still believe that he's able to do exceeding abundant above all you can ask, think, or imagine. Is there anybody here who knows something about uncommon favor? Is anybody here who knows something about uncommon favor? I said, is there anybody here who's ever seen uncommon favor? Uncommon favor at the doctor's office. Uncommon favor at the lawyer's office. Uncommon favor at your office. Uncommon favor at the bank. Uncommon favor in your house. Somebody, anybody, everybody, help me thank God for uncommon. Won't he do it? Won't he do it? Help me encourage your neighbor. Shout yes, shout yes, shout yes. Because if the Lord will do it for your neighbor, surely, surely, surely he's able to do that thing for you. No matter what happened yesterday, no matter how many battles you lost, no matter how wounded you may feel, or the odds are stacked against you, I've come to declare that your life matters. Yes, somebody shout it with me. My life matters. I said, shout with me. My life matters. Now
help me encourage your neighbor. Come on, nudge him a little bit and tell him, wake up to hear this. I want to tell you, your, come on, tell him your life matters. Tell him your life matters until they believe it. Keep telling them your life matters. Your life matters. Somebody doesn't believe it. You can't yet receive it. But I'm so glad that the Bible is replete of examples of one life mattering. Yes, I'm so glad that God is able to show us an example of how your life matters. Yes, I know there are people in the Old Testament who the Lord used to do a mighty work, but can I rush to the cross because of one life? You know his name. Because of one life, our life has been changed. Because one life stepped down into time from eternity. Because one life left paradise and came down to earth. Because one life went about healing the sick, raising the dead. Because one life hung out with the loner, the loser, the left out, the looked over, the depressed. Because one life came down. He said, if the world hates you, keep in mind that it hated me first. If you belong to the world, it would love you as its own. But if not as the world loves you, because I've chosen you out of this world. And one day they whip my Jesus all night long. Yes, they spat on my Savior all night long. He was led from hall to hall. Yes, and he never said a mumbling word, because he knew that his life mattered. Yes, they made him walk one Friday up that Via De La Rosa. Yes, the way of suffering and shame. Yes, they placed a crown of thorns upon his head, spike in his wrist, spike in his instep, and nailed my Jesus to an old rugged cross. But they didn't know that one life mattered. He said, I'm fine when I'm lying down, but if I be lifted up from the earth, I'll draw. All men, all women, all people, black and brown, I'll draw all men unto me. And here he was on that old rugged cross. Because of one life, he taught us how to forgive. Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. He taught us how to hope. Today, you shall be with me in paradise. He taught us how to love. Woman, behold your son. Son, behold your mother. He taught us how to suffer. My God, why hast thou forsaken me? He taught us how to stand. He said, I thirst. He taught us how to win, no matter what. When he declared over his situation, it is finished. He taught us how to trust in the midnight hour by saying, Father, into your hands I commit my spirit. Yes, and if you think that an eclipse is something that can block out the sun for 4 minutes, then come with me to Calvary. Yes, for our Savior hung between earth and heaven, and the sun got a text that is the S-U-N and said, Son, I'm sorry, but we can't have two suns shining at the same time. F-U-N said goodnight, Jesus, and the sun refused to shine from the sixth to the ninth hour. Because one life, your life, Jesus said, I'll die, but anyone takes my life, I lay it down. And if I lay it down, in 3 days, I'll lift it up. So he died. I feel real bad, but didn't he die? He died. Didn't he die? He died one Friday. He died. Yes, he died. And he stayed in the grave all night Friday. Help me tell the story. He stayed there in the grave all day Saturday. He was there with death all night Saturday night. But something happened around the break of day. Early, early, somebody shout early. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy, joy, joy. Will you grab your neighbor and say, joy comes in the morning. Hold on, hold on, hold on. Because early Sunday morning, he got up with all power in his hand. Power over death. Power over disease. Power over decay. Power over everything. And see, anybody here want to say thank you? All power that was in his hands is now in your hands. So lift your hands and receive it. Your life matters. God is moving. God is working. God is shifting. God is sifting. Because your life matters. So be not dismayed. Whatever time, God will take care of you. Beneath his wings of love abide. God will, God will, God will. Come on, if you believe it, open your mouth and thank God that your life matters. If you receive it, open your mouth and bless God that your life matters. You have joy, you have peace, you have purpose, you have rest, because your... I will open your mouth and declare victory in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and declare uncommon favor in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and declare healing in the name.
We heard a word from on high. When you receive that in your spirit, that your life matters, then you will begin to understand that the person next to you, their life matters. And the person on the other side of you, their life matters. And the persons that are in front of you and behind you, their lives matter. Hallelujah. If you don't mind, just for a moment, would you stand to your feet? This is a moment where the invitation is going out to the one, the two, the three, the four, or more who have not given their lives to Christ. This is the opportunity for you to accept the one whose life we've just heard about really matters, to accept him into your life, to be your Lord and your Savior, to be your first and your last, to be the God of your life. If you're here today and you have not accepted Christ as your Lord and your Savior, here is your opportunity to step out into the aisle, and one of these deacons will bring you up here to the front. I'm going to do it like this. If you have been baptized, received the Holy Ghost, you have given your life to Christ, then I'm going to ask you to go ahead and take a seat. And I don't want anybody looking around. Just be within yourself. If you have not, if you are still standing, the invitation is to you. We don't believe here at Central in picking fruit before it's ripe. So if you are not ready, just keep coming. Just keep allowing the Lord to speak to your heart. And when it's your time, before I even open my mouth, you will be down here ready to give your life. So if you are not ready, we are okay with that. We love you just the same. God loves you. So if you are not ready, go ahead and have a seat. But if you are, we extend our hands to you. Amen. Let's thank God for a saved house. Amen. It's not 11:30 yet, so... Got a few minutes? No. We are... Oh, hold on. Tiffany? Is that who I'm looking for?
No.
Where she is. Okay. You not coming up here? Okay, there's people online waiting for me to do something, so. You coming up here?
Good morning. Good morning. You all know when you all see me, it's always time to celebrate something, right? All the time. So again, my name is Tiffany Brooks. This is my co-chair, Dan Redden, and we are here on behalf of the Pastors A team, just coming because we know that this week we celebrated a holiday, right? We celebrated a holiday and Pastor Riley's birthday, and we are just so excited because his life matters. And we just love and appreciate him, and we just want to show all of our love and appreciation all the time. And so if you have not had the opportunity already, we invite you to show your love and appreciation directly to Pastor. There are ways to give that you can see on the screen there. You can give a card, you can do a Cash App, whatever you'd like to do, a nice word. Hopefully you had the opportunity to fill out some of the little papers out there, because we know that our pastor thrives on words of encouragement. And so if that's all that you can give, that is more than enough. And so we just pray that you would just continue to encourage him at this time. And we just, again, now I know we had a little secret for Pastor, and so I just kind of want to show you all what the secret was, because I think you all did a good job in keeping that secret.
So what we have here is we have a photo album from all the people who submitted photos of Pastor and themselves. So we thank you all for those who have given. You can still get photos if you want to. There's still room in the photo album. So we look forward to those who still want to give. And I hope Pastor likes and loves this gift from us all.
Amen. Okay. All right, it's time to go.
just a couple more minutes. The clock says I have. Can we stand, please? Can we stand? I'm glad that we can laugh in church. Now, I hope that's a laugh with me and not a laugh at me. So if you would just, if you want to get connected, you may, but we're just going to do our benediction, and then we're going to go home. So let's bow our heads. God, we thank you so very much for what you have done in this place on today. Thank you, O Lord, for the reminder that we all matter, that our lives matter, that we are important, that we are somebody. God, I thank you for how you have used the pastor on today. Lord, we ask that as we move from this place, that you would be with us, that we would carry you not only out the door, but carry you with us as we move through the rest of this week. Now unto him who was able to keep us from falling, to the one true God, who is our only God, who is the number one God. To him be all the honor, glory, dominion, and power. In Jesus' name, let every heart say amen. Thank you.